I just stopped in for a bag of beans. We're running low at home.
Oh, well, good.
I'd be happy to help.
Oh, 2 pounds of the Kenya blend. You remembered.
Hard to forget.
Excuse me, you haven't taken my order yet.
Most people find that blend too intense.
Not me. I like something that holds its body on my tongue.
We're all right. What's he doing now? I believe he's bagging her beans.
Oh, I'm so excited. Eric over there is taking me to a club to hear his band tonight. Oh, I know it's not my regular night off, but I'll switch it with Saturday if that's okay with you.
Well, maybe you should try spicing things up a bit.
You mean boudoir-wise?
For starters, yeah.
Like how?
Well, the two of you could, Well, you could... Well, it's you and Maris, so you could... I'm stumped.
Niles. Niles.
I'm sorry, Frasier, but something horrible has happened. Maris kicked me out.
Dear God, why? What for?
Well, my plan was to leave a treasure map downstairs for Maris with clues that would lead her to my whereabouts. Then I'd hide in the linen closet and wait for her to find me.
Dressed like that?
Actually, no. At the time, I was wearing only my eye patch. Although, technically, is it still an eye patch if you're wearing it on your...
Stop!
I just got off the phone with Maris. She's in Arizona for the weekend.
Why?
Well, she said she was so shattered by the experience, she had to fly to her favorite spa to contemplate the future of our marriage from a mud bath.
Well, it'll probably be good for Mrs. Crane. Eric thinks the earth is very grounding.
Eric! Must everything always be about Eric?
I could help you prepare something. I have a late date with Erica. An elderly aunt, Erica. Look at this. It's beautiful.
It's a glockenspiel. We bought it on our honeymoon in Zurich. I brought it down from the attic to remind Maris of better times. It used to play beautiful music, and now it doesn't. How's that for irony?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't want to spoil your reunion with Mrs. Crane, but... Eric broke up with me.
Niles Crane?
Oh, Maris!
Where are you? What do you mean you can't come home?
Oh, Maris never made it back. She's stuck in Arizona.
I gotta get Daphne out of there! For disaster! Got a vulnerable woman and an unstable man in a gothic mansion on a rainy night. The only thing missing is someone shouting Heathcliff across the moor.
Dr. Crane.
Yes, Daphne.
We're losing the fire.
No, we're not. It's burning with the heat of a thousand suns.
But it's down to its last embers.
Well, then, I'll put some wood on it.
I suppose I just fall in love too fast. The minute I feel that spark, I just give my heart away. Dr. Crane, your glockenspiel has sprung to life.
Maris.
You really love her, don't you?
You know, I do. Love is a funny thing, isn't it? Sometimes it's exciting and passionate, and sometimes it's something else. Something comfortable and familiar. That newly exfoliated little face staring up at you from across the breakfast table. Having a laugh together when you see someone wearing white after Labor Day.
I hope someday some man will feel that way about me.
Frasier!
My God, have you two gone mad? You'll regret this for the rest of your lives!
What are you talking about?
Well, the two of you here alone, the fire, the candlelight, the 90!
Dr. Crane, you didn't think that Dr. Crane and I were... Dr. Crane! You have some nerve to imply that your brother would do anything so deplorable. Why, just moments ago, he made a beautiful speech about how much he loves his wife, how he cherishes her excruciating little face, and how they laugh at white people. That didn't sound right.
Close enough.
I wanted you to stop standing here in silence. A night like this calls for music. Daphne, please, some wine for all of us. Niles, join me at the piano, please. Are you sure everything's all right?
Absolutely. Frasier, my glockenspiel is working again.